Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Good friends, now we have did the why was the classification of element was needed in periodic table. So for that, Dobiner's trait had made a very great influence in the classification of the periodic table. So what is actually Dobiner trait? Let us talk about that. So now we are going to talk about what is Dobiner's trait. So Dobiner was the first to study the trends in periodic in the properties of elements. So Dobiner was the one who have studied the trends in the periodic of the periodic table, that is for the property of the elements. So what does it had made to know it as that he arranged the elements in various groups, and each group consisted of three elements having similar properties, and hence they are known as triads. So this is the arrangement of the few elements that he added and made a group of that, and that's the reason he was the one who had classified those groups earlier by arranging those group of elements in such a manner that they all had a similar chemical properties. So for example, he had made a few groups or a few triads, and for which we have this two examples so as to make you understand that this were one of those triad or one of those group of elements that Dobiner had made. So as we could see that these are the elements like lithium, sodium and potassium. They had an atomic weight of 7, 23 and 39 respectively. So as that of the calcium, strontium and barium, it had 40, 88 and 137. So this all elements have a similar chemical property, while that of even this calcium, strontium, barium, they all have the similar chemical property. And as they were known as the triads. But there is another kind of sequence that was been shown in the Dobiner's chart, and what is that? Let us think about that also. While arranging those elements, it was being observed that in each triad, the middle element had an atomic weight almost an average of the atomic weights of the other two elements. What does this imply? This implies that suppose if we are talking about lithium, sodium and potassium as to be a group, or we could say as a Dobiner triad. So in this, the middle atom element is basically nothing but sodium. And it has been found that the other two elements other than sodium, that is other than the middle element, that is the lithium and potassium, if we have calculated the average of this thing, that is if we have added up 39 plus 7, and if we have made an average, that is 39 plus 7 divided by 2, then the overall answer would be almost equal to that of the middle atom. That is, for now it is sodium. So if we do the average of 7 and 39, let us see what we get. We have got 23. So therefore this shows that it had a particular sequence with that of the first and the third element when we are talking about a Dobiner trait. And talking about this thing also, that is for calcium and strontium and barium, because strontium is the middle element which has an atomic number of atomic weight of 88, while that of the calcium and barium had an atomic weight of 40 and 137. So let us take the average and let us see whether it is validate for this or not. So it has been found to be 88.5, which is almost equal to that of 88. So this is what the Dobiner trait had classified the elements in which the middle element, when it had talked about a triad, so that the middle element had an atomic weight to average of that of the first and the third element. So this is what the first classification was being made by the Dobiner. So there are other also like chlorine, bromine and iodine, even they had a same kind of a similar kind of triad that we could see that whenever the bromine, if we calculate the atomic weight of bromine, that was be found to be the average of the atomic weight of chlorine and that of the iodine. So now, because of which, the Dobrynin had played a very great influence in classifying those elements when we come to the periodic table. So even the Dobrynin played a very vital role. So, but this classification did not work for large number of elements. It had only a few group of elements which had followed the Dobrynin trend and which was easy to calculate that what would be the atomic number of the middle one or the middle element. But it was not validated for each and every element or each and every group that we are observing in the periodic table. So that was the limitation of Dobrynin. But it is very interesting to know that that was a very good sequence in classifying the periodic table. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood that what is Dobrynin trend, and you share this video with your friends. And yes, don't forget to subscribe to VK Rajan. Thank you so much.